VSA methods can be overloaded. Static methods also can be overloaded. Can constructors be overloaded? Let's see. Can constructors be overloaded? Takedown heading is constructor overloading. Can constructors be overloaded? Kavya, mute your microphone, Kavya, please. Can constructors be overloaded? Let's see that whether can constructors be overloaded or not. Right click, new, class, demo, constructor, overload. I'm going to write system.out.println. Class 9. I am going to have a class called class 9. Public void add, sorry, 9, right? I am going to create a constructor also as 9. System.out.println. This is 9. Now, int a comma int b. I am going to have a 9 constructor with two parameters. Int c is equal to a plus b. System.out.println c. A comma int b comma int c, int d is equal to a plus b plus c. System.out.println d. That's it. D. Now in I have 3 9 constructor, 9 int a int b comma int 3 9 constructors I have. This is a constructor. Constructor name is same name as class name. Now let me have a method called public void Bangalore. System.out.println. This is Bangalore. Bangalore. Now how to call the Bangalore method? Sorry. Now, if I create an object 9, n1 equal to new 9. Now, if I run this, what will be the output of this program? What will be the output of this program? This is beginning and this is 9. Okay. This is beginning and this is 9 because it will call the constructor also. But if I want to call the second constructor, if I want to call the second constructor, that is this constructor, then how can I call? Can I call n1.9? Can I call n1.9? No. Can constructors be called with objects? No. Then how can you call with n1? Can constructors be overloaded? First answer that. Can constructors be overloaded? I cannot call n1.9, that is not possible. That is not possible to call. That is not possible to call. Just a minute. 9N1. I cannot call the 9 constructor like that. In that case, how can I call that method? Tell me. Is it, sorry, not method. Can I call that constructor? No, I cannot call. In that case, can constructors be overloaded? Yes or no? Either it might be right or wrong. Try. Yes, constructors can be overloaded. How? If I pass the parameters argument here, then only second one will be called. I want to call both first one and second one. In that case, what I can do?
Return.
Why you have to use return? Can constructor has a return type? Can you read the properties? What is the third property of constructor? And then why are you telling return? I clearly mentioned that point also very clearly. Now what to do in that case? In the sense 9 N2, create one more object, new 9 10 comma 20 10 comma 20. Now if I call this, automatically the second constructor will be called. How to call the third 9 9 N3 equal to new 9 10 comma 20 comma 30 9 N3 equal to new 9. Sorry. Now can constructors be overloaded? Yes. Now I am able to overload the constructors also. Yes, I am getting that output. Now if I want to call this, if I want to call this Bangalore method, how to call the Bangalore method? Do I want to call with N1? Do I want to call with N2? Or else do I want to call with N3? Or else, do I want to create one more object and I want to call it? Or else, can I call with any of the object? Can you tell me how, what is the correct answer? Multiple choice question. How can I call the Bangalore method? There is a Bangalore method called Bangalore inside the 9 class. Then how can I call? With only N1, do I want to call? Can't I call with N2 or N3? Then that will be your interview question. No object created. Yes, very good. You can call with any of the object. Object is object always. However, the way you create it doesn't matter. Bangalore. That's it. That's it. This is constructor overloading. This is called constructor overloading. Renuka, mute your microphone, Renuka. You have some disturbance. This is called constructor overloading. Can constructor, if in interviews if they ask, can constructors be overloaded? Yes, you can tell yes. And you can write a small logic like this. Don't implement any if statements, for loops and all. If they ask precisely about constructor overloading, then talk about that only. Okay? That's it. Take down heading as constructor overloading and take down this. First we have saw method overloading, then we have saw static overloading, now we have saw about constructor overloading also. Take down this quickly. Guys, if you have any doubts, you can ask me. Okay, no doubts, take down. this I hope everyone have done. Next. First we have some method, take down heading as packages. Take down heading as packages. Now, right click. Okay, I have one. It's a very important topic, guys, packages. Now I am going to create a new package. Right click, new package. I'll name this package as demo pack 1. Demo pack 1, finish. Under this demo pack 1, I am going to create a new class. Right click, new class. I'll name this as demo sample. Public static void main, finish. Listen carefully. Now I am going to have a method called system.out.println. This is beginning. This is beginning. Beginning. Now I am going to have a class called class 1. I can have a class 1 here again because this is in another package. Public void Bangalore. System.out.println. This is Bangalore. I'm going to have another method, public void Chennai. System.out.println, this is Chennai. Now if I want to call the Bangalore method and Chennai method, how can I call the Bangalore method and Chennai method? How to call the Bangalore method or Chennai method? One equal to new one. Yes. Then if I want to call the Bangalore method, how can I do that? O1 dot Bangalore. Then if I want to call Chennai method, how can I call Chennai method? O1 dot Chennai. Okay, O1 dot Chennai. Now O1 dot Bangalore and O1 dot Chennai. O1 dot Bangalore and O1 dot Chennai. Now if I run this, I am getting this is beginning, this is Bangalore and this is Chennai. Yes. Bangalore and this is Chennai. Now this is how I call a method if it is there inside another class. Now imagine that the class is above this class. Inside this program only it is there, but it is above this demo sample. Now how to call the Bangalore method? Normally how will you call it? Create object for Bangalore. Can you create object for methods? Is it possible? James Gosling has not identified. He is the founder of Java. He has not identified how to create object for methods. He has identified only how to create object for classes. Okay, I can create for object for class 1. 1, O1 equal to new 1. Then how to call this Bangalore method or Chennai method? Can you tell me how to call the Bangalore method? How to call the Bangalore method, guys? O1 dot Bangalore. Then O1 dot Chennai. Yes. O1 dot Bangalore and O1 dot Chennai. Either the class might be located below or else it might be above the program. Wherever it might be inside a program, you can just create an object for that method. You can create an object for the class and you can call those methods which are there inside that particular class. Understood? Yes or no?
Yes.
Now, I am going to create a new program. Right click, new class, demo. I am going to have a class called class 2. No public static void main. Inside this only, I am going to have two methods. Public void Mumbai. System.out.println. This is Mumbai. Public void Pune. System.out.println. This is Pune. This is Mumbai. This is Pune. Now I want to call Mumbai method and Pune method, which is there inside the class 2, but this class 2 is inside a different program. Now I want to call Mumbai method and Pune method, which is there inside the class 2. How to do that? Can you tell me? I need to call Mumbai method and Pune method, which is there inside the class 2.
We can create an object with the class 2.
I can create object, but that is in a different program, not in the same program. Still, okay, you have said 2 T1 equal to new 2. As per your suggestion, I will go. Then, how to call Mumbai method and Pune method, which is there inside the class 2? T1.Mumbai. T1.Pune. T1.Mumbai and T1.Pune. Yeah, this is what we can do. Run this. This is beginning, this is Bangalore, this is Chennai, this is Mumbai. Either the program, either the class might be below, or else it might be above, or else it might be in a different program also, no need to worry. You can just create object and you can call those methods. But that should be in the same package. That should be in the same package. It should not be in the different package. Are you understanding this? Yes. What happens if it is there inside the different package? That is what we are going to see. Let me create a new package. Right click, new package, demo pack 2. Right click, new class 3. Inside the demo pack 2, I have created a class called class 3. Inside this, I am going to have two methods, public void Delhi. System.out.println, this is Delhi. Delhi, public void. Delhi void Pune. Sorry, not Pune. I'll name this as Noida for confusion. System.out.println. This is Noida. Now, I want to call Delhi method and Noida method, which is there inside the class 3. This class 3 is inside a different package. Call demo pack 2. Then how to call Delhi method and Noida method, which is there inside the demo pack 2, which is there inside the class called class 3. How to call that? Normally, how will you call it? Tell me that. Normally, how will you call it, guys?
We call by class 2.
Yeah, create object for?
3.
Class 3. Let us start creating object for class 3. 3. T1 equal to new 3. Yes. See, but while I am creating object for this class 3, T2, let me name it as T2. Ranjana, you don't unmute Ranjana. Others you can unmute and answer. You have some background noise. 3, T2 equal to new 3. But it is throwing an error. Why? Why? Because this class 3 is inside a different package. It is not in this package. It is in a different package. In that case, what we have to do? If it is there inside the, if it is inside a different package, then you have to import that package. You have to import that package. How to import? Have to import that package. Import demo pack 2.3 class. I am importing. That's it. Now the error will go away. Yeah, see, that error has gone. Now t2.delhi, t2.noida. That's it. See, if the class is inside the same package, either it might be in the same program or else it might be in a different program also. You can just create object and call it. But if it is in a different package, if it is in a different package, then you cannot do anything. What you have to do here in that case, in the sense, if it is in a different package, then you have to import that package, and you have to import that package. You have to import that package, and you have to call them. You have to create an object, or you have to call it, or else it will throw you an error. See here, I'll tell you a small story now. Now I am in Bangalore. Imagine that I am in Bangalore. I want to purchase iPhone 12. I'll go to shop, I'll go to somewhere, to Sangeeta Mobiles or somewhere, and I will purchase it and I will use it. Okay, then I can start using. I don't want to do any extra things out there. Now, if I am purchasing somewhere in Karnataka also, I can just purchase it and I can use it. If I go to Delhi also, what I can do, I can directly purchase and I can use it. I don't want to do anything beyond that. I can take it back to Bangalore and I can use it and do anything. Because it is in the same country. It is in the same country. Delhi, this, Bangalore, all these things are in the same country. Even though if it is in a different state. See here, same program refers same state. Package refers country here. Imagine that might be next week I am going to USA. When I go to USA, I'll purchase an iPhone 12 in USA. And I will be starting using there. Up to there, if I use, that's not a problem. When I am coming to India, when I am coming to India, throughout the, when I am exiting from airport, I have to pay the import duty for the mobile, whatever I am bringing from US. If it is from a different, if I am using something which is there in a, from a different country, then I have to import. I have to pay the import duties, then I have to use that. The same way, if you are trying to access some classes which are there inside the different packages, then what you have to do, you have to import that. You have to write an import statement, or else it will throw you an error. Okay, let me start writing one more class inside this. Let me right click new class 4. Public void Agra. System.out.println. Agra. Now I need to call the method called Agra method. For class or Agra method. Inside for class I have Agra method. How to call that Agra method which is there inside the for class? That for class is in a different package. If I create object for class 4, for f1 equal to new 4, then how to call that f1 dot Agra? But while I am creating object for class 4, it is throwing an error. Why? Because that is in a different package. I need to import that particular class also. So that what I am going to do, import demo pack 2.4. Yeah, done. Now that error has gone. F1.agra. Likewise, I'll be doing that. Now, if I want to call any method which is there inside another class, I can create object, but if it is in a different package, I need to import that package. Tomorrow, if I create one more class called class 5, and if I try to access those methods which are there inside class 5, inside the demo, which is there inside demo pack 2, then I have to write import demo pack 2.5. Then writing each and every time, what I can do here is demo pack 2.star. Star refers all the classes inside that package. Star refers all the classes inside that package. That's it. Now, inside that package. That's it. So, take down this. Now, I hope everyone have understood the packages concept, right? Yes. Now, what you do is take down this structure, take down this demo pack 1, demo pack, this structure, whatever it is there. Take down the structure, then take down the demo sample, this program, then you can, the other programs are just two lines. Take down the structure, then you will be able to understand that while you are practicing. Also take down this. Thank you. Have you completed, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, take down this next program. What's it all about? Packages. Next, take down heading as if condition. Take down heading as if condition. I hope everyone knows how if condition, most of you guys will be knowing, but there is something quite different to learn in this if condition. Let's see that. Right click, new class, demo if. System.out.println, this is success. Else, System.out.println, this is failure. Now if I run this, what will be the output of this program? What will be the output of this program? If I run this, what will be the output of this program? This is success. Are you sure? Yes, this is success. Because if the condition is true, if condition will get executed. I have hard-coded value as true. If I make it as false, if I run this, what will be the output of this program?
This is failure.
Right? This is success, this is failure. If it is false, if condition will work only if the condition is true. If it is not true, else condition will get executed. Right? If I make it as not false is equal to true. Okay. In that case, if I run this program, what will be the output of this program? This is success. Because the condition is true. Not false is equal to true. That's why it is printing and this is success. Not false is equal to true. It will print us this is success. Not true is equal to? Why? The condition is?
False.
Not true. With not true is equal to false. If it is false, of course, else condition will get it. Now, finally, what we have understood, if condition will work, only if the condition is true, or else it won't get executed, or else else condition will get executed. That is what we have understood. Now, what I am going to do here, I am going to have a string, actual is equal to ABCD. String expected equal to ABCD. If actual dot equals expected. Now, if I run this, what will be the output of this program? I have took two strings, actual and expected. I have compared both. If both are same, the condition will become true, this is success will get executed. Or else it will print us this is failure. Now if I run this, what will be the output of this program?
This is success.
Understood? Everyone, have you understood what it is happening here?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Actual dot equals to, if both are same, this will get executed, or else will get executed. Now, A, B, C, C, D, small letters. If I run this, what will be the output of this program?
This is failure.
Okay, now, even though small letters and capital letters I have to ignore, in that case what I can do here is actual equals ignore case expected. Now if I run this, what will be the output of this program? It will ignore the case sensitive, that is equals and equals ignore. This is success. Have you understood this, everyone? Yes. Now if I run this program, what will be the output of this program?
This is failure.
Because both actual and expected are not same. Even though if I ignore the case sensitive also, something is mismatching. That's why it is printing us this is failure. Have you understood this difference between equals and equals ignore case? Everyone? Yes. Yes. Actual A, B, C, D. Now if I run this, what will be the output of this program?
This is success.
Now actual dot equals. Actual dot equals. What does this equals method returns?
Boolean.
Actual dot expected to, it returns Boolean. Since it returns Boolean, I have to hold that in the Boolean variable.
Now actual dot equals to expected, this is saved under status. Now instead of this actual dot equals to expected, what I can write? I can write a status, because these both are clubbed inside the status. Now what happens initially? Actual will be assigned with ABCD, the expected will be assigned with ABCD. Actual dot expected equals to expected, since it returns boolean, boolean means true or false. Now the status will be true or false in this case? True. Now if it is true, then what will it will execute? If condition will get executed. This is success will get executed. That is what it happens here. Hope everyone have understood this, right? Yes. Now I am going to make it as ABCD 1, 2, 3. If I run this, what will be the output of this program? Why? What? In that case, what will be the status here? Status is false. Actual dot equals to, it returns boolean. The boolean value is false now. The boolean value is false. Now, if it is false, of course else condition will get executed. That is, this is failure. It is going to print as, this is failure. This is failure. This is failure. Now, if both are not same, it is status is false. Now, what I am going to make it as? Not false. Not false. Now if I run this program, what will be the output of this program? This is success. Why? Because status is false. Not false in the sense, not false in the sense it becomes true. That is why it will print as this is success. This is quite a tricky thing what you have to, you have to understand what not makes. Not makes completely opposite. That's it. Nothing beyond that what it makes. Okay. That is how if condition works. If condition will get executed only if the condition is true. Okay, take down this into your notes. Take down heading as if condition and take down this. Have you completed? Okay. Take down next heading is reversing a string. Now, I'm going to give this as a homework. Reversing a string. Click new class. Create a new demo. Reverse. Public static void main finish. Okay. Here, I'm going to have a string. String reverse. String, sorry. Actual or something. I'm going to have Selenium. Now, whatever the value I give here, it has to, you have to write a logic. You have to write a logic here. You can search it in Google or do whatever you want. Okay. You have to write a logic here, and whatever the string I give here, that it has to reverse and it has to string it. Don't just type a system.out.println. Sir, I have reversed it and I have printed MUI. Not like that. Okay. You have to write a logic here. Try to implement that logic. Write a logic how to reverse a program, reverse a string and print it. Whatever the string you give there, that it has to reverse and it has to print it. Not only Selenium. Tomorrow I might change this to Selenium training also. Training also. It has to reverse this completely and it has to print it. Try to check that output and send a mail to me. Send a mail or you can WhatsApp me the program, whatever you want. It's just some 5 to 6 lines of code. Okay, that's your homework for you.